As a photographer and creative, having a computer monitor that is color calibrated and accurate is so important for so many reasons. This is the BenQ PD2700U, and it's a monitor I've been using for the past year now. And in this video, I'm gonna explain all the things that make this monitor better than all the other options out there, and we'll talk a little bit about color science and color calibration. When it comes to purchasing a monitor, most people don't really know what to look for. For most people, frame rate, resolution, and price is all that matters, and I'm not gonna lie, that was me too. For the longest time, I was editing on a super old monitor that I got for free, and it was great for day-to-day stuff, but when it came to editing, it just made my life worse. I would spend hours color grading a photo or a video just to send it over to my phone or my iPad, and it looked completely different. I remember it was so annoying because I would always have to send these media files back and forth and blindly edit to finally get a result that I actually wanted. After working on this monitor for several months, I finally had enough. I started to do a ton of research on why displays display color differently and what to look out for when buying a monitor. The first thing you want to look at when buying a monitor is its color gamut. In other words, what color space or gamut does it support? Every display, whether it's your smartphone, TV, or computer monitor, displays a specific color gamut. These are usually sRGB, Adobe RGB, Rec. 709, NTSC, or DCI P3. Things like the web and social media were created in sRGB, and that's why you see a lot of computer monitors supporting or displaying sRGB, including some of our smartphones. Rec. 709 is used in high definition television, and that's why we see a lot of TVs or projectors supporting the Rec. 709 color space. For example, when I create these YouTube videos, I film in a log color gamut or color profile, and then I transform that in post-processing to Rec. 709 color space and then slap on a little color grade until we get to here. Adobe RGB extends richer cyans and greens than sRGB and supports most colors achievable on CMYK color printers, which makes it great for photographers who are going to be printing their work. DCI P3 is similar to Rec. 709. It's a wider color standard than sRGB and shows 25% more colors with deeper blacks. When a monitor says it supports 100% of the sRGB color space, that means it's capable of displaying every single color within that color space. Ideally, when looking for a monitor, especially for photography or other creative work, I would suggest at the least getting a monitor that supports 100% of the sRGB gamut, and for video, 100% of the Rec. 709 gamut. Next, let's talk about delta or delta E values. Delta E values look like this. Delta E is a measurement from 1 to 100 of how much a displayed color can differ from its original or input color. The higher the number, the less accurate, and the lower the number, the more accurate. This image right here is blue. The RGB values are 00255. It doesn't matter which display I open this photo on, the RGB values of the image that was uploaded are 00255 blue. However, if you have a monitor with a delta value of 6, that same blue photo might appear like this, a completely different color. Now imagine working on a monitor with a delta value of 6. You spend hours working on a color grade just to upload it somewhere or send it over to your phone or look at it on another device and it looked completely different than it did on your computer. Lastly, let's talk about bit depth and why it's important. Bit depth looks like this. 8-bit contains 16.7 million colors, and 10-bit contains 1.07 billion colors. Which means a 10-bit display is capable of displaying more colors, but also show a smoother transition between colors. Nowadays, cameras like my Sony a7 IV actually film in 10-bit color for video, so having a 10-bit display allows you to see all those 10-bit colors more accurately. Another thing that you need to understand is that our eyes are super adaptive to colors. If the display you've been using for the past year has a slight green tint to it, there's a high chance that your eyes have gotten used to that tint. So you might wake up one morning and you start editing a photo and you notice that the photo has a slight green tint to it. And you think to yourself, maybe you just didn't set the white balance properly. So you fix it. You grab that tint slider and you drag it over to the magenta side to balance out the colors in the image. Everything looks good. You send it over to your phone and you realize that it has a huge magenta tint shift to it. This was because your photo never needed that tint adjustment to begin with. Your white balance was fine. It was just your display that was throwing everything off. Now that you know this, let's talk about the monitor I've been using for the past year, the BenQ PD2700U. It is color calibrated from factory. It supports 100% of the sRGB color gamut as well as the Rec 709 color gamut. It has 10-bit color and a delta value of 3. This monitor is amazing, but it's not 100% accurate, and this is because the delta value of 3. The difference between a delta value of 1, which is the best you can get, and 3 is not that big of a difference. It's just barely noticeable to the human eye, and it actually doesn't affect the hue that much, only saturation, and you can see that in this example here. A little bit of desaturation I could deal with, but when the hue of my colors in my image are shifted, it's a nightmare to work with. Now, when I was searching for a monitor, it was between the Asus Pro Art series or the BenQ lineup. I ended up going with the BenQ because it had all the specs I needed, but also a lot of features I use day to day. One of these is the low blue light mode. If I'm not editing photos or videos, you'll find me in this mode. When I'm in this mode, I find I don't get tired and my eyes don't hurt even after sitting on my computer staring at the screen for over 12 hours. When I'm editing photos for Instagram, I quickly switch it into the sRGB gamut. And when I'm editing videos like this one here, I switch it into the Rec 709 gamut. I love that it's a 4K panel and that I can watch my YouTube videos at full resolution, but also how punchy the colors are. But most of all, I love that I can edit a photo or color grade a video, send it over to my phone, and it look exactly the same as it did on my computer monitor. Now, if you're researching color calibrated monitors, there's a good chance that you've seen a color calibration tool online and thought to yourself, can I just pick up a crappy monitor and then color calibrate it to be accurate? The answer is no. A color calibration tool is used to calibrate your display and adjust the colors. One thing you need to understand is that a display can't display colors that it doesn't have. If that display only supports 80% of the sRGB color gamut, you can't color calibrate it with one of these tools and get it to 100% sRGB. Displays can shift over time and blues can start to look teal, reds can start to look oranges, and that's where you want to use a color calibration tool to get those colors looking back to how they used to be. So I would suggest not to get a crappy monitor if you're a creative, and instead, here is a list of some of the monitors I suggest. If you want to check them out for yourself, I'll leave them all linked in the description down below. So starting off with my monitor, the BenQ PD2700U, you already know the specs, so I'll just throw them up on the screen. And just to give you an idea of what I was looking for, I compared monitors that were all 27 inches, 10 bit, delta values of under 3, and supports at least 100% of the sRGB and Rec 709 color space. Anyway, the next monitor is the BenQ PD2725U. This is similar to the PD2700U, both 4K, 10-bit color, delta value of 3, but on top of supporting 100% of the sRGB and Rec 709 color gamut, it also supports 90% of the DCI P3 gamut. Moving up to some of these monitors that were specifically designed for photographers in mind, we have the BenQ SW270C. This monitor has a delta E value of 2, so we're getting a little more color accuracy, 10-bit color depth, 100% of the sRGB and Rec 709 color gamut, also 99% of the Adobe RGB, and 96% of the DCI P3 gamut. But it is a 2K monitor if resolution is something that matters to you. This monitor comes in at $799. Stepping up to this monitor's bigger brother, we have the BenQ SW271C. This one is a 4K monitor, but you actually get more with its 2K version. It doesn't support the Rec 709 color gamut, and it only supports 90% of the DCI P3 color gamut, as opposed to 97. Now, nobody said this was budget friendly, so if you want the best of the best consumer computer monitor, I would suggest the Asus ProArt PA27UCXK displayed. This monitor has a delta value, basically the best you can get. It's super color accurate. It's a 10-bit 4K display, supports 100% of the sRGB and Rec. 709 color gamut, 99.5% of the Adobe RGB gamut, 97% of the DCI-P3, and 83% of the Rec. 2020 gamut. This thing is a beast and perfect for all the content you want to create on it, but it does come in at a price tag of $2,900 American. Now, I was actually in the middle of editing this video and grabbing screenshots to add to this video, and I found a monitor that is either the best bang for your buck right now or a glitch. This is a ViewSonic Color Pro. It has a delta value of 2, a 4K 10-bit display, and I gotta read these specs off because it's just so much. It supports 100% of the sRGB, Rec. 709, Adobe RGB, EBU, and SMPTEC color gamut. It also supports 98% of the DCI-P3 and 108% of the NTSC color gamut. This monitor will be coming out soon and it'll be priced at $1,000 USD. I can guarantee you that if this monitor had a delta value of 1, you'd see this well over $2,000. Anyway, let's get back to the video. Like I said, if you're interested in checking any of these monitors out for yourself, I have them all linked in the description down below. I hope you learned a little bit about color when it comes to displays and how they affect your content. If you found this video useful, make sure you hit that like button. Let me know which display you use to edit off of in the comments, and hit that subscribe button if you want to see more content like this, and I'll see you in the next one.